This is our kind of Australian Watergate, if ever I've seen one.
On the attack.
There are serious questions here, questions of character for Anthony Albanese.
I think the Prime Minister owes the Australian public answers.
He's either got to resign or the Prime Minister's got to show the strength and sack her.
The opposition pushing claims Labor Minister Katy Gallagher misled Parliament.
Well, no, she didn't. Katy is a person of enormous integrity.
You had allegations by a Liberal staffer that another Liberal staffer had a sexual assault in a Liberal minister's office, and somehow Katy Gallagher has some responsibility. Like, this is bizarre.
The issue? This comment from Gallagher in 2021, as she and Penny Wong batted away claims they knew about Brittany Higgins' allegations, which Bruce Lehrmann denies, before the story broke.
I was told by one of your senators 2 weeks before about what you were intending to do with the story in my office, 2 weeks before.
No one had any knowledge. How dare you?
It's all about protecting yourself.
Text messages provided by Higgins during the police investigation and leaked to media this week suggest otherwise. Brittany's boyfriend texting her 4 days before she went public, saying Katy Gallagher is going to come to me with some questions you need to prepare for. She's really invested now. Haha. She's an old friend, so you can trust her. And later, Katy Gallagher messaged me. She's angry and wants to help.
If you're taking the text messages on exactly what they say, then people were not being completely truthful.
Katy has made her position very clear that she's very comfortable with the statements that she's made.
Overnight, there were more leaks on Sky News from a five-hour pre-interview the project did with Brittany Higgins, including criticism of the Liberal Party's approach to diversity.
We've got a pretty bloody good track record on pre-selecting individuals on merit who so happen to be Indigenous people and people of mixed background. It is the woke who believe in the diversity pick and quotas.
The source of the leaks, including the recording and the contents of Higgins' phone, remains a mystery. Network 10 lawyers today claiming a calculated media campaign is being waged using the leaked court material in an effort to dissuade witnesses from giving evidence in the defamation case brought by Bruce Lehrmann. Notably ignored in much of the mudslinging, the human at the centre of all of this.
This is a pretty vile attack from Dutton and Linda Reynolds, putting at risk the mental health of someone that's very vulnerable.
Remember what this is about. It's an allegation that a person was raped in Parliament House, 50 metres from the Prime Minister's office.
We have to remember Brittany Higgins is a very vulnerable young woman, and I think making her the punching bag of a political attack is really unsavoury.
10's National Affairs editor Hugh Rimmington joins us. Hugh, what is it exactly that Katy Gallagher has to answer here?
Well, there's a couple of things on foot at the moment. One is the suggestion that she might be referred to the new National Anti-Corruption Commission relating to, among other things, the payment that was given to Brittany Higgins that went through the Finance Department. Katy Gallagher has said she didn't address it herself personally. The Attorney General said he did that. So a suggestion that possibly did Brittany Higgins get paid more than she otherwise would have done because of some, you know, partisan interest in supporting her. We'll see where that one lands. But on the text messages, we've seen no text messages actually from Katy Gallagher. All of them are by inference in the messages between David Shiraz and Brittany Higgins. They seem to suggest that Katy Gallagher knew about it before she said she knew about it. And if she has misled the Senate on that point, then perhaps a statement on Tuesday when the Senate resumes might be a useful thing to put it all to bed.
Hugh, what might the consequences of this be? And I'm talking political or otherwise.
Well, the political consequences are that it goes on for a while. You've heard from the opposition the claim made that any politicisation or the use of Brittany Higgins' case for political benefits and purposes would have been morally bankrupt. Now, if we look back to the times, it was enormously prominent. It was a subject of numerous questions in Question Time. It helped build up the image that Scott Morrison was out of touch with women in Australia. We know at the last election, women largely abandoned the Liberal Party or the coalition parties at that election. So it certainly was part of something that did damage to the government. So was that morally bankrupt if that was being weaponised to that end? That's the opposition's claim, essentially. You know, that will have to land wherever it lands. But at the same time, it's being weaponised again now. And at the heart of it all, as you point out in your report there, is Brittany Higgins. And in documents that have been put into the federal court today, lawyers for Brittany Higgins say she is suffering. And in all the misdirection and mistruth in the source of all of, in the middle of all of this, you'd have to say that her statement that she is suffering is almost certainly true.
Hugh, can you help anyone watching this understand why all of this material, text messages, audio, is suddenly in the public domain?
This is material that was given, so we learn from court documents, to initially the Australian Federal Police, the Canberra-based police, and then to the DPP. One or the other of them then handed them on to the defendant in the case, Bruce Lehrmann, and his lawyers. So the suggestion on foot in documents in court today from the Ten Network is that somehow they have reached the public domain through leaks to the media. Now, Bruce Lehrmann's lawyers say it didn't come from them and they are now trying to get hold of those documents. Wherever that all lands, plainly there has been an abuse of process, because in the case of someone who's been accused or is accusing someone else of a sexual crime, the victim in that has to hand over certain material, and that should not be presented to anyone else, particularly when it is not actually used in the criminal trial that follows.
Hugh Rimmington, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.